the celestial navigation. The celestial navigation uses the space object, such as the Sun, the Moon, or the other stellar as a reference to guide the flight direction and the flight attitude of the prober. Clearly, the star sensor should be employed in this method. As a kind of optical measurement device, besides the visible light camera, the infrared camera, the ultraviolet camera, the X-ray camera, the gamma ray camera, and so on can all be used. Many methods have been designed for the celestial navigation, that is, the angle measurement based navigation, the distance measurement based navigation, and the speed measurement based navigation. The angle measurement based navigation uses the angles among the Sun, the other planets, the planet satellite, the asteroid, or the comet to carry out the autonomous navigation. The distance measurement based navigation mainly employs the detection result of the arrival time difference between the X-ray pulsar and the standard pulse of the solar system center to estimate the navigation information and the time offset. In addition, the speed measurement based navigation utilizes the optical Doppler effect to implement the navigation. Table 3 presents the popular methods of the celestial navigation. A kind of classification of the celestial navigation technique. The celestial navigation at least has three advantages. First, as a kind of optic measurement device, most of the celestial navigation systems are immune to the traditional electromagnetic interference problem. Also, their working reliabilities are comparable high. Second, its navigation accuracy is good. Because the spatial distance between the celestial body and the prober is really large, the navigation precision can be very high if the star sensor performance and the corresponding data processing algorithm are proper. Third, most of the celestial navigation devices can work all time long as the corresponding celestial bodies are visible. The celestial navigation also has some shortcomings. The biggest problem is that some devices cannot be used in the complex light environment. For example, the strong environment light or the cosmic rays will affect the application effect of these optic devices seriously. Another drawback is that some celestial navigation devices cannot give out the sequential output because of the target star occlusion problem. Comparing with the inertial navigation technique, the celestial navigation is still immature, and most techniques do not get the test of the practical flight mission. In future, the new modeling technique of the orbit function, the new measurement theory of the star, and the new estimation method of the navigation information can all be researched extensively to improve the application effect of the celestial navigation.